כפר הנוער בן יקיר זה כפר נוער שבעצם נותן מענה לילדים מכל רחבי הארץ שלא מצאו את מקומם גם בבתי הספר האחרים וגם לפעמים בשכונות שהם נמצאים. לרוב גרים בשכונות מצוקה, בשכונות שהשוטטות ברחוב והאלכוהול והסמים נפוץ בשכונה. אם את לוקחת ילדים שמגיעים לפה בכיתה ח', השאיפה והחלום שלהם זה לחיות.
אולי אין לי חלום.
ילדים מגיעים לפה בלי חלומות, בלי לדעת מה הם רוצים לעשות כשהם יהיו גדולים, בלי שאיפות אחרי שנפלטו ממסגרות, עם המון בעיות התנהגות ובעיות בבית ספר, בעיות לימודיות, ופתאום היה להם איזשהו אופק.
לפני שהגעתי לפה, היה לי את האמת קשה להישאר במסגרת אחת, ואז שהגעתי לפה, פה הכל השתנה את האמת. והרגשתי שיש מישהו מאחורי ששומר עליי כביכול ומגן עליי בשביל. הייתי יכול לדבר איתו, לשפוך לו מה שיש עליי, כאילו, מה שעובר עליי, לספר לו הכל.
לפני שהגעתי הפנימיה, חצי שנה הייתי בבית, לא למדתי. וכשהגעתי לכאן פשוט לא רציתי ללכת, הרגשתי כאן מאוד בטוח. ואני רק מרוצה מזה, כי היום אני אוטוטו מסיים בגרות מלאה.
הגעתי לפה כי לא הסתדרתי בבית ספר הרגיל. התחלתי ללמוד, להשקיע בלימודים. קיבלתי תעודות טובות. שנותנים פה עוזרים בלימודים, נותנים יחס אישי.
אם לא הייתי בא לכפר, ננסה לתת כאילו כמו שצריך, אבל באסון גדול. והכפר כאילו סידר אותי כביכול, מכל הבחינות.
החלום שלי זה תכלס בקריירה הצבאית שם, להגיע למכונאי מוטס.
שנה הבאה אני הולך למכינה, ואחר כך אני הולך לעשות אולי שירות במודיעין, סייבר.
יש לי קודם כל חלום אחד, לסיים הנדסאי בחשמל. ומשם להתגייס לחיל האוויר, ואני רוצה תמיד לשרת כמה שיותר הכי גבוה, כאילו. אם אני יכול לתת מעצמי, לתת כמה שיותר, כאילו.
אז אני מזמינה אתכם להיות שותפים לסיפור ההצלחה שקורה פה. מזמינה אתכם להיות שותפים, לבנות פה את הדבר שישדר לכל התלמידים שאנחנו מאמינים בהם, והם יכולים להיות הכי טובים שהם מסוגלים.
Rachelly, I've been working in Ben Yakir for the past 8 years in various roles. I was in charge of the relationship with communities like yourselves that are part of Ben Yakir in heart, from far and in close. And in the past 3 years, I've been teaching in the school in Ben Yakir English and helping our students achieve a full matriculation in English. And for students who come from Ethiopia, to achieve the goal of a full diploma with English is a very, very high goal. And gladly, most of them, almost 90% of them are achieving this goal. I think the only stable thing that we had in the past year was instability. The school year continued. We had a summer camp. But we were in touch more and more with the families, supporting them with both help in the supermarket and trying to help some of the parents even find jobs. So it's been a challenging year, and we hope to see the end of it and get back on our feet for the families and for ourselves. So I wish I could say that domestic violence started with coronavirus and will end with coronavirus. But unfortunately, in our little personal experience, that's not the situation. About, I think, almost 3 years ago, one of our students lost his mother to domestic violence. It was traumatic for the student, for his peers, for us as a staff, and of course, for the family. As an English teacher, I gave them an assignment to write about a difficulty they had in life. And one student handed in a paper saying, well, my difficulty in life is preventing my father to beat up my younger siblings. There's no doubt that a stressful situation like the coronavirus and lack of an income and lack of stability and being everybody at home together all the time And the stress from the outside is something that increases domestic violence. So it's definitely an issue that is right in front of us and needs to be dealt both therapeutically, both by understanding where we are. The family has to understand and our students themselves have to understand what their role is and what they're supposed to do and how not to feel guilty or to take it into their hearts. When our students come and tell us that they don't want to go home, even when they have the chance, we have, you know, this red light that that appears. And after asking many questions, even being aware more and more to the stress that's in the house and to the domestic violence that they meet when they come home, we felt together with Keren Hayesod that we need to do something a bit different. Every group has its own social worker that's in touch with the families and works with the students, but we felt that we need to work in the community and to work to help the students understand what happens at home, to help the families themselves gather together and get the tools to get out of the situation, to get out of the stress, to get out of the need that they feel in order to build a stronger life. We are budgeted, of course, as you know, by the Ministry of Education, but the budget works in the village, in the youth village. We don't have the money to go outside and to reach the families at home and to help them at home in their own setting. And that's why we need the help. And that's why we need the collaboration and the money to work on the projects at home with the families in order to build a future both for the families and for our students. So my husband is a sergeant in the army. I remember when the Lebanon war was over and all the soldiers came home and my husband's unit was the last one to leave Lebanon. 20 days after the war was over, I got the first phone call. And I remember those 20 days where everybody was, you know, it was over, the war is over, everybody's safe, everybody's home. But for our families, for Ben Yaakov families, the war isn't over. So helping them and intervening at this time, at this point, where everybody's let go, but they're still feeling the stress. They still haven't found jobs. They still open the fridge and don't know how to deal with whatever's not in there. This is the time that we need your help. I believe the Israeli government will realize that. And I believe the social workers, the communities will realize that. But we fear that it's going to be too late. That, you know, the wheels of bureaucracy take time. And it's our chance to do something good right now when they need it, and not when the next crime will happen. And then we're going to say, where were we? We're going to start with a pilot that thankfully it's going to be in Ben Yaakov. And we're going to choose five families, working with these five families and understanding the benefits and how to do it well. We're going to choose the families with the help of the social worker here in Ben Yaakov and the social worker in the community that's going to work together with us. And after that success, which I'm sure is going to be a very, very good success, we can enlarge the program together. We want to build this program. We want to make it work in order to prevent the next crime. Our students need so much from us. They need us to help them close gaps. They need us to help them grow up. They need us to help them teach how to take responsibility. So we need your help in order to make the home a safe place for them, in order for everything that we build here together with them not to collapse the minute they pass the doorstep to their houses. I want to thank you for zooming into this event and for supporting the project. To Perth Women's Leadership for being part of this project and for pioneering a new project in Israel and supporting us in our efforts to help the women in Israel from way home in Australia.